how do you calculate L of T sine 2T? See, how do you calculate L of T sine 2T? Here, sine 2T is multiplied by T. Sine 2T is multiplied by T. A function is multiplied by T. So, Laplace transform of these functions can be calculated by another formula. So, that we are discussing here. Multiplication by T raised to N. If any function is multiplied by T raised to N, then what does its Laplace transform? We have the theorem. If L f of t is equal to f of s, this is the Laplace transform. Okay, then L of t raised to n into f of t. F of t is multiplied by t raised to n. Its Laplace transform is equal to minus 1 whole raised to n into d raised to n by ds raised to n f of s. See, if the power of t is n, you take minus 1 whole raised to n and nth derivative of, see, d raised to n by ds raised to n means it is the nth derivative of f of s. What is f of s? F of s is L f of t. Okay, n times you differentiate f of s. If f of t, suppose it is multiplied by t, then n value will be 1, isn't it? So, minus 1 whole raised to 1 d by ds of f of s. F of s, you have to differentiate one time. If it is t square, differentiate f of s 2 times. If it is t cube, differentiate f of s 3 times. And this formula is called multiplication by t raised to n. Actually, this is the questions based on this is not included even in your syllabus. But in the project work of in the textbook of Erwin Krasick, this formula is partially it is defined there. Okay, so that is why I decided to discuss this formula here. Okay. See, we have the formula L of t raised to n f of t is equal to minus 1 whole raised to n into d raised to n by ds raised to n into f of s. Okay, let us take the first example. Evaluate L of t sine 2t. Here sine 2t is multiplied by t. So, you can use multiplication formula. Okay. So, what is the value of n? N is 1. So, in this formula, when you are substituting, it is minus 1 whole raised to 1 d by ds of. See, d by ds. D raised to 1 by ds raised to 1 means d by ds of f of s. So, what is f of s? You see the formula. F of s means it is L of sine 2t. L of sine 2t is L of sine 8t form. So, 2 by s square plus 4. That value should be substituted here. Okay. So, it is d by ds of 2 by s square plus 4. Then you just differentiate. So, minus of 2 into, see, 1 by s square plus 4. What is the derivative? We don't want to apply quotient rule. Okay. It is of the form sum 1 by x. If it is 1 by x, what is the derivative? It is minus 1 by x square, isn't it? Instead of x, let us suppose this is our x. So, 1 by x form. It is minus 1 by x square. So, minus 1 by s square plus 4 the whole square. So, in total, it is minus 2 by s square plus 4 whole square into derivative of s square is 2s. Therefore, this is minus 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 into minus, it is plus 2 into 2, 4 as divided by s square plus 4 the whole square. So, this is multiplication by t raised to n formula. Okay. Now, one more formula, that is division by t formula. Division by t formula. This says that we have the theorem, if L f of t is equal to f of s, then L of f of t by t. If f of t is divided by t, then what is its Laplace transform? And the formula is integral s to infinity f of Whereas in division, if it is divided by t, the formula is integral. Integral s to infinity. See the limits. It is from s to infinity. Capital F of s into ds. What is f of s, sir? It is L f of t. So whenever you are given a function f of t, suppose it is divided by t, the first thing is you find f of s. Find its Laplace transform and integrate this Laplace transform from s to infinity. It gives division by t. And you can't write this as some t raised to minus 1, ct raised to minus 1, and it belongs to the previous case. Don't do that. See, n is, in this case, n is minus 1. We can't do derivative. We can't find derivative. Okay, so cannot use the previous formula. Okay, so if f of t is divided by t, use division formula, that is integral s to infinity f of s into ds. See, we have the division formula L of f of t by t, that is equal to integral s to infinity f of s ds. Now look at the first question. Evaluate L of sin t by t. See, which function is divided by t? It is sin t. Sin t is divided by t. So you can assume sin t as our f of t. Okay, so sin t as f of t, then by division formula, it is integral s to infinity f of s ds. What is f of s? F of s means it is L of f of t. That means L of sin t. L of sin t is 1 by s square plus 1. Therefore, integral s to infinity 1 by s square plus 1 ds. Now, what is the integral of 1 by s square plus 1? This is of the form 1 by x square plus a square. So, by integral formula, it is 1 by a tan inverse x by a. You have learned some, I think, in plus 2. Okay, so this is tan inverse of s from the limit s to infinity. Now, you substitute upper limit and lower limit. So, tan inverse of infinity minus tan inverse of s. Now, what is the value of tan inverse of infinity? Tan inverse infinity means it is pi by 2. Okay, so tan pi by 2 is infinity. Therefore, tan inverse infinity is pi by 2 minus tan inverse of s. Now, 90 minus tan inverse, it is cot inverse. Okay, 90 minus tan inverse is cot inverse. So, 90 minus tan inverse s is cot inverse s. This is the final answer. Okay, so this is division formula. So two important formulae we discussed in these sections. One is multiplication by t raised to n. That is a derivative. That is in terms of derivative. Whereas division formula, division by t, it is in terms of integral. So you learn these two definitions. Okay. So once again, these two formulae, one is the multiplication formula and the second one is the division formula. The multiplication formula says that L of t raised to n f of t is equal to minus 1 whole raised to n into d raised to n by ds raised to n into f of s. This is multiplication formula. And the division formula, L of f of t by t is equal to integral s to infinity f of s into ds. This f of s is the Laplace transform of the numerator, f of t, Laplace transform of numerator. So in the first one it is derivative and the second one it is integral. I hope you all understood what I discussed in this class. Thank you.